Here we are once more back in the gym. And if you're wondering why my head's so red, it's because I took niacin and niacin with flush. So for those of you who have experienced niacin with flush, you know what I'm going through currently. I like it, you know, it warms me up. And I do that because today is deadlift day. Deadlifting for me is always a bit of a hit and miss, due to the nature of always having, like, you know, being injury prone and putting my body through a lot of punishment. Deadlifting is something that sometimes I can do for weeks on end, once a week. But sometimes, you know, when we have matches, we come out of matches, and especially like my hip region or my lower back or my glutes or my hamstrings are blocked or injured or just hurting, I can't do it. So, so far so good for these last few weeks. So today is deadlift day. And funny enough, a lot of the same stuff that applies to warming up for squats applies for deadlifts. However, you have to target a little bit more in your glutes, a little bit more in your lower back, a little bit more in your upper back as well, in terms of like a pull motion to wake up all those muscles, because as you know, deadlifting is a compound exercise that targets pretty much almost every muscle in your body. You know, but primarily you want to warm up your hamstrings, your glutes, your lower and your upper back, your abdominal region, especially activate your core and loosen up your hips to get your mobility. So, you know, if you're looking for some more warm-up stuff for this stuff, go to my squatting video or go to the squat day and pick those, and then I'm gonna add a few here today. Place your legs almost like in an S shape. From this angle, you're gonna turn each and every way around 10 times to get those axial rotations in your hip joints. And as you see, as much as you're doing, you're kind of coming forward a little bit. Kind of go back to this position, kind of start stretching out a little bit. You've seen this part if you watched the squat video, you know that stretching is something that I take very serious. This whole warming up process is going to take for about 20 minutes, so let's not show you 20 minutes of stretching, but I'll guide you through what we're doing, same as we're always doing. Now that I've done the initial part of my warming up, which is foam rolling, tactical rocking, rolling, and various stretches, I'm getting into a little bit more of a proactive way of warming up. Like I said, when it comes to deadlifting, I really have to warm myself up. Again, that's why I took the niacin, so my face is kind of red. But another thing is that deadlifting is obviously a very high-driven, stance-based movement. You have both feet on the ground and you pull from your legs and basically your entire body. So I always like to warm up, or at least warm up, roll my feet out. Now, I use this little, I guess this is a cricket ball. I use a cricket ball for it. They're relatively cheap. And you can use these for anything, man. You can use these for your upper back. You can use them for your lats. You can use them to roll on your shoulders, your biceps, your triceps, your forearms, all these things that you need to like tenderize or prep when you work out. So I like to work out bare feet. Now, obviously I have a home gym, so I have that. I have that option. A lot of gyms don't have that, but I've been into a lot of places where I could take my shoes off and I wear workout socks. Specific ones, and I can at least roll out my feet. It's also like a really good feeling. And the other thing is, what I do is I use this to dig through my calves as well, because your calves have a really essential role to play during the deadlift. A lot of people don't prepare their calves. please stretch out your calves, prepare your calves, do some jumps, like small explosive jumps to kind of like prime them for, hey, you know, we're going to do an explosive pull movement. After that, I'm going to use, we're going to go over here for a second, because this is one of those other things that I'm a big fan of. And I want to grab it, and now I can't find it. Oh, well, here we are. It's these things. They're called slings, slingshot. When I started using these things, a world opened for me. I use them before working out, but I also use them before wrestling matches. So if you're a wrestler and you're watching this, if you have one of these, and you have this, and you have a workout band, and maybe, you know, if you feel like it, get a good like a fast rope, skipping rope. Any active sports that involves you, either when it's like MMA or wrestling, kickboxing, man, I think you could even use this for like if you're a football player. Anything that has dynamic movement, anything that requires your body an extensive time to warm up. If you have a small little bag, which I have here, like I've got one of these string bags. I carry this with me all the time whenever I go to shows on the road, obviously with all my other stuff, but this one specifically. And I put in, just threw them on the ground, there you go. I threw in these things alongside of a jumping rope, and I use these for my warm-ups continuously. If you are a wrestler looking at this and you're thinking to yourself, you know, what should I do for warming up? Well, to be honest, it's the same thing you do with, you know, warming up for the you know, these workouts. And if you follow any of my other videos and you see that I'm warming up, use those stretches, use those warm-ups right before you get into your matches. You know, take a good, I don't know, your matches up in an hour, you know, you're ready to go, you got everything. Just find a good place to like sit and relax, and you know, grab your foam roller, grab your rope, grab your cricket ball, grab your sling, and start moving around. Start activating the muscles that you need. Because I will guarantee you, from the perspective of an 18-year-long veteran of this sport, and I don't really use that word veteran a lot because I don't like to label myself as a veteran, a 18-year practitioner of professional wrestling, I can guarantee you that it will put longevity in your career. Stretching, warming up, all that stuff. And I'm not talking about push-ups so that your chest is all pumped up and you look good in the ring. I'm talking about functional warming up. We're gonna roll up my feet. I'm gonna use this band, I'm gonna use this sling, and we're gonna slowly get into deadlifting. Yes, sir. Next up is the sling. Do some walking around. You can put these on two positions. You can put them just above your knees, but you can also put them around your ankle. And all it will do is increase the resistance of the way you're walking. You have these in different like strengths and sizes. Now this might seem like an awful product replacement thing that I'm about to, product placement right here. But actually my wife sells a bunch of these things. You can also find them on Amazon. I just think the ones that my wife have it cool, has their logo on it. And they're, you know, I use them too. And if you've seen my wife's video on them and her workout, actually a lot of that stuff you can use to warm yourself up for squatting or deadlifting. Now, sometimes I think that, you know, men in particular who watch that stuff, think, oh, that's not for me. You'd be surprised how much it will improve your squat, how much it will improve your deadlift, just from doing the warm up that way. And not just that, like I said, I reference this back to professional wrestling or combat sports or sports in general. Anything you do that requires your hips to explosively move or move in general. Slingshots, slings, whatever you want to call them, are super handy, and I advise anyone to get them. Now, whether you get them from Amazon or you get them from whomever, yes, that's, you know, my wife in the background, doesn't matter. Just invest in. They're not expensive. They're relatively cheap, and they will last you a very, very long time, and they will add a new dimension to your training, to your working out, to your warming up. Done that about 3, maybe 4 times, depending on how you feel. Some of you might only have to do it twice. You can start going towards a little bit more active, active movement, or like more like muscle specific warm up. Right now, we're gonna go to the there we go, hyperextension. I'm having to film everything by my hand because the wife also started to work out. Here we go. This guy, a little hyperextension action. Nothing too crazy, just 3 sets of 10, and we're gonna superset it with some jumps. Now you might be asking yourself, why the jumps? Because I wanna train my body, I wanna tell my nervous system, I wanna have explosive pull motion. So that's why the jump. In combination with these guys, you can do those 2 to 4 sets depending on how you feel. Like I said in a previous video, sometimes 2 sets for me, it's all it takes. The second I go into a third warming up set, I kind of feel like I'm starting to like get into my workout a little bit, if that makes sense. I feel like it affects my workout, which I don't want, because I want to be fresh, not going into the workout going, ooh, I'm already kind of feeling burned out. Yeah? All right, after you've done all this, you can start heading over to the bar and start warming up at the bar. For the more explosive dynamic stuff, we're gonna start moving into more deadlift-based movement, but also, like I said, you gotta start getting your upper back and move your shoulders back so you're telling your body what to do. A lot of this stuff has to do with like the memory of the body and telling your body how to move, because the more you're proning yourself to do that, the easier in a bit like your lifts are going to be. So we're gonna do around 3 sets of 10 of these. They're relatively easy. Just grab a band, but you can do them. You can do them with dumbbells as well. Just light dumbbells. It's just about having tension continuously. Kind of step out so you build that tension. Move back. Almost go to a straight leg. Not straight leg. Like a normal deadlift stance. Or if you would have your normal deadlift stance, you can, you know, go here. We're gonna go a little above that. So we're gonna almost go here, and from that angle, we're gonna go up, pull your shoulders back, roll in, keep it 3 seconds, and go back. And build that tension on those hamstrings. Up, squeeze your glutes. Between 6 and 10 of those, 3 sets, and then we're gonna move up to more dynamic stuff.
So obviously before starting, we need to know how much we're gonna lift today. So we are in week 6, meaning that I have 3 sets of 6 reps on 70%. Meaning that we're going up from the more power lift, low rep movement to a little bit more of a higher rep situation for the next coming 2 weeks. But in the next week, so week 7, we're gonna go from 70% to 75-80%. So it definitely gets heavier. And after that, after we've done so much low repetition and a little bit higher repetition, we're gonna go into one more week of a little lower, and then we're gonna go into our PR weeks. This is everything to just prime to see how much max strength we have built over the course of 2 months. So I'm gonna calculate and I'm gonna get back to you. One last tip. Have a notebook. Notebooks are essential. It doesn't matter if you stay on track on which page you're writing. Of course, that's preferable, but just have something you can have notes on so you can write down so you know where to backtrack and know where to look and know what you did before. Yeah, very, very needed for progression. So warmed up for about 2-3 sets. We're working on 280 today, which isn't exactly crazy, but it's a good preparation for the week after, because the week after we're going on 80-85% with higher reps. So this is more of like an in-between set of an in-between week that helps me prepare physically for the next week when everything does get a little bit more heavier and the higher rep count with the higher weight really starts to count. So let's get to it. So that was 3 sets. Right now, for the last set, which is more of like a finisher of the exercise, we're not done working out, just the exercise itself. We're gonna strip down back to the second set of warming up, which in my case was 225. And I'm gonna blast out, I wouldn't say as many reps as I can. I'm gonna stop around 3 to 1 rep below the point where I feel like complete exhaustion, just to give it a little, a good finish.